الحمد لله الذي بنعمته تتم الصالحات وبفضله وكرمه ترفع الدرجات وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله أفضل من حج ابتغاء رفيع الجنات صلوات الله وسلامه عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين أما بعد فيا عباد الله أوصيكم ونفسي بتقوى الله عز وجل فإن تقواه خير زاد الحجاج قال سبحانه وتعالى يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون وقال سبحانه وتزودوا فإن خير الزاد التقوى واتقون يا أولي الألباب respectable family honorable brothers and sisters in Islam we great and powerful hujjaj we perform the hajj at the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Makkah al-Mukarramah we don't meet for that we continue for praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the almighty Allah when a true in favor of them nine good things them go come to accomplish the Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala when a true in mercy neither elevate we enslaves them towards the higher status them of life we praise them and testify that na inna the only one we deserve worship na inna the one we the first them people them and the today people them and all the creations them then they turn to and if any form of worship we testify again for say the prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam the almighty Allah in servant and messenger the best of mankind whether ever hajj in order for reach the higher heights of iman respectable brothers and sisters in Islam Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala don't bestow in favor upon me again for lay honor and bless some of enslaves them we get now this world enslaves them we get now a country and enslaves them we get now this we jamiatul haq Allah don't bless them they don't hasten for go perform what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala don't make obligatory upon them when they perform the hajj in the sacred house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala then do so due to the ambition we then get and the interest we don't develop inside their heart for let them win the reward the great reward and blessings while Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala don't put in store for the one day when they perform hajj the rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam tell we say man hajja falam yarfuth walam yafsuq raja'a an dhunubihi ka yawmi waladathu ummuh say anybody who perform hajj in not transgress and do the things them way they disturb and spoil the hajj he go return back again from in sin same way he don't commit just like the day when Imam bin Bonan came to this world. Now, inna the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam again tell we say, al-hajj al-mabrur laysa lahu jaza'un illa al-jannah. Say the hajj, where Allah don't accept, you not get a reward, way better reach the paradise. Therefore, my brothers and sisters in Islam, fahani'an, goodness done day, congratulations done day for the one that will perform Hajj. Goodness done day for them, for where they don't win the forgiveness and mercy from the Lord, when they most forgiving and the most merciful. Goodness done day for them, as so many good things that they're able to accomplish within a very short time in their life. Respectable family, then, we always not been good perform Hajj. We not been fortunate this year for lay. We head towards the house of Allah. But we say we head towards Allah. As we journey towards Allah, not a lifetime journey. Now Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in the one way, we all head towards, we all focus towards, in the one way, we all worship. For second one day, the season of Hajj, even be the season of we all. The Ashhurul Hurum, the great sacred months, even there for we all. The 10 days of Dhul Hijjah, with all of the goodness with the inside it, even there for we all. The Yawm Arafah, the day of Arafah, with all the blessings that we get, even there for we all. We have been joined the Hujjaj them on the day of sacrifice. For sacrifice we animals them. We've been joined them for greeting Allah, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, la ilaha illallah. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, wa lillahi alhamd. We've been joined them for slaughter with animals them, we praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We joined them for so many goodness then. For sake of that, brothers and sisters in Islam, it is always necessary that after we Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless his slave with such kind of a favor, with such kind of a bounty, let it happy for this kind of a goodness. But the happiness we forget, not to the fact that he will only for accomplish the Hajj, or accomplish goodness them with the inside and worship here where they worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but rather the happiness if will come more due to the acceptance what would they expect, what will they hope, say Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala if they accept we worship them we did. Now so the first and pious people them in town, whenever they do good work, then they're happy. They're not only happy for the work they don't do, but rather than they're happy for the acceptance of the work. Simply because they read the verse where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say in certain book, إِنَّمَا يَتَقَبَّلُ اللَّهُ مِنَ الْمُتَّقِينَ. Surely, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala they accept from the righteous people then, from the God-fearing people then. Yes, so that make even tell una una they go for Hajj, you say what is that wadu, unu prepare yourself, una care go una belongings them, una get una provision with una una they go, you say but in the khair zad attaqwa, the best of provision the piety. That piety, the way you check them, when you combine them with the acceptance, we all matter don't promise it, go accept from the pious people, for make me and you will feel good. For anybody where Allah accept you work, that acceptance is an evidence for say, you know, one part of the people they were amongst the pious people, them. Respectable brothers and sisters in Islam, the first 10 people, them be very much concerned about this acceptance. An acceptance, we supposed to feel them, we supposed to sense them. How we go sense them, and how we go feel this acceptance? Then walk there, the no fever, like then top up them where you born you top up in the register. Say you don't burn up. Enough people like that one day. Now what could they, what will they do for Allah? Bet, signs and day. Signs and day. Evidences and day. Indicators and day. Whenever we see them one day, the level feel good say, we work what we do and we reach Allah and Allah be accept them for we. My brothers and sisters in Islam, scholars they mention certain indicators them for the pilgrims and for the one day where they perform Hajj. They say among the greatest of signs where they should say Allah don't accept the Hajj what we don't do. Now for lay the Hajj, he return back again from a Hajj where he don't perform, he return in a situation way better pass that one way he be go with. He return in iman he don't increase. He return in anxiety for upkeep the commands of Allah and in anxiety for keep away from the warnings of Allah, he don't grow. He return with a heart. We turn to Allah. He return with a heart. We they fear Allah. He return with a heart. We know the desire except what Allah desire. He return with a soul. We very strong and powerful for do more righteous work them. A soul. We very much determined for continue for obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And win in nearness. If we return with embodied parts, each and every part of him body, it compete for do good work, and like how it compete for keep away from the bad work them. Now so the scholars them say, now that makes some of the salaf then say, thawabu al-hasanatu ba'daha. He said the reward of good work what you don't do, now for let you do good work after. If you see yourself after when you don't do good work, you don't do more good work then, that one day now clear evidence for sure say, the past good work when you don't do, Allah been done taken for you. Respectable brothers and sisters in Islam, we fumble them, we the pilgrims say, we come on Hajj this year, they let them not see you, except amongst the one they were anxious to perform Salat Pani Jama. Let them not see you except amongst the one they were they compete for the righteous work them and good ones. Let them not see you except as an individual we always the sense and realize the presence of Allah. That Allah they see you, that Allah they hear you, that Allah aware of each and every single action where they do in your life. Let them not see you except among the one day where they strive for do good things them at all time. Not among the one day where you go say, when me I come on Hajj, me a holy person now, I for be lazy in among for sit on a house. Let you day na the front line for be amongst the one day where they contribute towards national development, society development, nation development. If for day among the forefront people then. Now that they expect of you. Because what you do, with the Hajj you don't perform, you soul don't get more empowerment. Allah don't empower your soul. Allah don't strengthen your soul. And the strength of the human being, it not depend upon your body. It not depend upon your sense, like how it depend upon the power of your soul. With the Hajj, you're a very powerful individual. We can represent the human race any side. Not only that the spiritual side for can the masjid only, but for represent the human race that your office will say you day. Represent the human race that the side will say you belong, the society where you find yourself. Let you be a model for people that they look at and say this level emulator and level follow my katara. Respectable brothers and sisters in Islam, if at all yesterday, when the Hajj come, when the Hajj season it reach we all be in the compete. We all be in the make haste. For let me go perform Hajj. because of the goodness within inside there, the brothers them can we compete back again bah, for the other good work them back again now in life. Can we compete? Can we allow we life let it be? A life where full of competition for do the things that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants. For say there are so many other work than they will be for do. Apart from the Hajj, we will go win the pleasure of Allah. We will for compete fun. And some of them work than they're very simple and very light. It is amongst them dhikrullah. For always they remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. A couple of authentic hadith where Bukhari reporting certain book from Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu for said the Sahaba then came to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He said, Ja'a al-fuqara ila Rasulillah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Faqalu, they can't complain. Then say, Dhahaba ahlu al-duthur min al-amwali bin darajat al-ula wa al-na'im al-muqim. Then say, the wealthy people, the one that will get money, they said they don't go before. They don't win all of the goodness. All of the high status in the don't get them. What you do? You saluna kaman usali in the pray, just like how we say they pray. Wa yasumuna kaman asum, then they fast like how we say they fast. Walahum fadlu min amwal, but then they get money. They get money, ya hujun, then they hajj with this money. Wa ya'tamirun, then they make umrah with this money. Wa yujahidun, then they make jihad with this money. Wa yatasaddaqun, then they get charity with this money. We will not get. This not be their concern. Now the time the messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam respond to them. He said, Ala uhadithukum bima law akhastum bihi lahiqtum man sabakakum wa lam yudrikkum ahadun ba'dakum. He said, una one make a tell una, make a inform una of kind of a work we una go do. Where if una do am una go beat them one day will be no come before una. And nobody no go before reach una, except the person we go do that same kind of work they will una do so. Then the Sahaba then say, yes indeed. Now I tell them, say, تُصَبِّحُونَ وَتَحْمَدُونَ وَتُكَبِّرُونَ خَلْفَ كُلِّ صَلَاتٍ سَلَاسًا وَسَلَاسِينَ. He say, make una go, they make subhanallah, walhamdulillah, Allahu Akbar, after every prayer 33 times. If you upkeep this particular dhikr, then yourself again, you don't catch the one the way you feel to sit and not pass you. Another channel of good work again where they mention where you find for levy upkeep now for they perform the Salatul Isha and the Salatul Fajr pan Jama'ah. All of the obligatory prayers them they all important for levy do on a Jama'ah. But then today they can trangle mainly for people them for perform the Salatul Fajr and Salatul Isha pan the Jama'ah. A couple of hadith where Abu Dharr radiallahu anhu. A report for say and the unasa min ashabi nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam qalu, that some people among the companions of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam they come. They say, Ya Rasulallah, dhahaba ahlu dhuthuri bil ujur. They say the people that will get money, they don't go with all of the blessing. They don't mean all the goodness. You saw Luna kama nusalli, and they pray the cow, they pray. Wa yasumuna kama nasum, then they fast the cow, we say they fast. Wa yatasaddaquna bifuduli amwalihim, but they get money within they spend and they get out with that money they put charity within they spend. And they tell the messenger of Allah replied them, Awalaysa qad ja'ala Allahu lakum salatal isha fi jama'ah ta'dilu hajja wa salatul ghada fi jama'ah ta'dilu umrah. He said, but una wait back. Allah don't make for una say if una pray the isha prayer upon the jama'ah. If go fiba like say na hajj una don't perform, if una pray the salatul fajr pan the jama'ah, if go fiba like say na umrah una don't perform, you don't see the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam talk say, man salla al ghadata fi jama'ah, thumma qa'ada yadhkuru Allah hatta tatlu ash-shams, thumma salla rak'ataini kanat lahu ka ajri hajjatin wa umrah. You see, anybody will perform the Fajr prayer upon Jama'ah. Then after the prayer, he make dhikrullah, so till the sunrise. Then he pray two rakah, that person there, they get the reward of person who perform Hajj and Umrah. But other version of the Hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, tamatan, tamatan, tam, complete Hajj and Umrah. Blessing that you get if you do this kind of a work here. So, respectable brothers and sisters in Islam, respectable Hujjaj of Baytullah al-Haram, let it not easy for we for spend money for go perform Hajj, then it difficult for we for let we avoid for do the things that we Allah in our want. A camper one statement where one of the Salaf and talk say, they say, Kafful Jawari an al Muharramat afdal min al tatawwu bil Hajj wa ghayrih. He said, for let mortal man he hold himself, let you seize yourself against the things that we Allah no lack, is more better than even for perform Hajj and Umrah. Fudail ibn Iyad rahimahullah, he said, La hajja wa la ribata wa la jihad أشد من حبس اللسان ولو أصبحت يهمك لسانك أصبحت في هم شديد. Fudail ibn Iyad, a great pious man, he say Hajj no day. He say for God, this is a big work them for God, for Sabbath, a security guard, for security territory, then they call us ribat. He say jihad no day. We tranga reach for lay mortal man a control in tonga. For lay mortal man a restrict in tonga. He say if you find yourself, your tongue, you concern so much about him, you so concerned about your tongue, you dey control him, you dey pick what you dey talk, then you don't find yourself in a very difficult something for do. Which means you don't find yourself in some tiofiba like somebody perform Hajj. Somebody perform jihad. Respectable brothers and sisters in Islam, sometimes we can so care about the outward performance or reaction, we can forget the inner side of our body. The inner part very important, equally like the outer part. The inside of we, na in the guide we towards the outside. Whatever we do outside the people and they see, now what in the tell the people them how the inside of we turn. So therefore, my brothers them, now let we make haste. Now let we make effort for purify we hearts them. Let the heart not focus except to Allah. Let the heart in no desire except Almighty Allah in desire. Let we develop, let we strengthen we hearts them by greatening Allah, by loving Allah, by fearing Allah, by realizing the presence of Allah. Let we honor Allah more than the honor what we get for any individual, for any work, for anything we be to say we do in life. Respectable Hujjaj, unale we be careful of that thing we normally it can spoil mortal man in work. That virus we can enter upon the work them, if we enter there, it is a destroyer. That virus of show, for lay and perform Hajj, so that people then go say, this man I don't perform Hajj. That virus we then call Asum'a, for lay and they do things, and while they people then talk about me in the fine way, people let them praise me. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he cautioned me. He said, man ra'a ra'a Allahu bih, wa man samma'a samma'a Allahu bih. Anybody where they do things and for them people then see them, then people then will see them no more, and then it will stop. Anybody where they do things for them people then yeri, now they no more it will stop, and the yeri where they go yeri, it no go benefit them, it no go reach to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. A kampama hadith al kursi we Almighty Allah say mana amila amalan ashraka fihi ma'iya ghairi taraktuhu wa shirka. Anybody we do any work, nay he make Allah partner with anything in this world, when that work day, Allah say at the left arm in a work, and any busy but I'm at all. Respectable Hujjaj, una not for be anxious, say, Pau Papa, and call una Al Haji or Al Hajjah. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, no one they call her al-Hajji. The Sahaba, then the Nabi, what they call them al-Hajji. If you then call it so, not a problem. But some man then they, if you do not call and so, a problem. If they begin remember all the sufferness we don't go through. We in actual fact, not a sufferness. If you check yourself now, you define and say whatever constraint what you've been doing in the holy lands, whether na Arafah now, whether na Muzdalifah now, whether na Mina now, for Lidom Usai not comfortable for you, eat food way not okay for you, walk at distances then, all of that one day you've not been doing for any human being. You've been doing for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So we've been doing for please Allah, that's strangely all in the convert, Allah the convert unto sweetness for you. Allah they make you they feel the pleasure of her. To the extent that the person will Allah accept the Hajj, among for, after all that constraint, you will wish when next year come, let it be among the team where they go back again. So, respectable brothers and sisters in Islam, when somebody return from Hajj, he can in country, they say they lack for the other person, they let it talk, they put him within the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam even they talk. A camp of Hadith of Abdullah ibn Umar radiallahu anhu report. He said, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, kana idha ghafala min ghazwin aw hajjin aw umra, yukabbiru ala kulli sharafi min al-ard. He said, whenever the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he will return back again, either from battle, from jihad, or will return from hajj, or will return from umrah, any side where he meet up, any high side, he will make takbir, Allahu Akbar, 3 times. Then after that, they begin to say, La ilaha illallah, wahdahu la sharika la, lahul mulku wa lahul hamd, wa huwa ala kulli shay'in qadir. Aibuna, ta'ibuna, abiduna, sajiduna li rabbina hamidun. Sadakallahu wa'da, wa nasara abda, wa hazama al-ahzaba wahda. This is the word where the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam begin to say. Ibn say this same dhikr wa una ibn say inside Arafat. La ilaha illallah. Wahdahu la sharika la. No, God no they will deserve worship except Allah. Inna in one. And not get any partner with him with him. Lahul mulku wa lahul hamd. Then gets the entire kingdom. And then get all the praise. Wa wa ala kulli shayin qadir. Na inna di wa will get power and ability for do anything. Aibuna with the return. Ta'ibuna, we they repent to Allah. Abiduna, we continuously they worship Allah. Sajiduna, we they make sujood li Rabbina. We they make sujood to the Lord. Hamidun, we they praise the Lord. Sadakallahu wa'da, Almighty Allah, he don't fulfill in promise. Wa nasara abda, Almighty Allah don't give victory to enslave. Wa hazam al ahzaba wahda. Allah don't defeat all of the parties them in one grain no more. Respectable brothers and sisters in Islam, not a problem for where people they come on Hajj, for where people they receive them and organize welcome for them, like how they organize and so, in a simple form. Not a problem for where we congratulate people they will come on Hajj and wish them well for the return, when you don't return back again from the Hajj. The scholars then say, if you greet somebody, we'll perform Hajj, he come back. Then you say to them, Takabbal Allahu Hajjak. May Allah accept your Hajj for you. Wa ghafara dhanbak. Make Allah forgive you mistake. Wa akhlafa nafaqatak. Let Allah replace for you that wealth where you spend, where you go perform Hajj. Let Allah add more for you again. Because the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he come for hadith for say, talk say, Allahumma kfir lil hajj wa liman istaghfara lahul hajj. It is say, oh Allah, forgive the person who go perform hajj and forgive the person where the person who go perform hajj it make an act of forgiveness for. That is only one the way una go ask for forgiveness for, una go pray for, una don't go pray for una self, una family them, una country as a whole. Allah, the answer, then kind of a prayer, then they, my respective brothers and sisters in Islam. Once more, we farm with them, let me feel good, let me feel fine. Now, then, Tia, they make let me feel fine. Now, this, now they rejoice, where Almighty Allah want for let me rejoice. Allah says, "Qul bifadlillah wa birahmatih, fabidhalika falyafrahu." Allah says, "Forsake in favors, forsake in mercy we them bestow upon me. Can we rejoice for them? Let we celebrate for them. The heart they celebrate, the heart they rejoice, because you don't accomplish one of the pillars of Islam. Lord, may Allah make it easy for me. Lord, who preserve this hajjah, so أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر المسلمين من كل ذنب فاستغفروا إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله على إحسانه والشكر له على توفيقه وامتنانه وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له تعظيما لشأنه وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله دعا إلى رضوانه صلوات الله وسلامه عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه وإخوانه وبعد. My respectable family, my honorable brothers and sisters in Islam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in favors them upon me and non-stop one. Almighty Allah in goodness them upon me and a continuous one. Allah don't do one for me again. Season inside season, season after season, Allah in favors them. It continue, my brothers, then. Today, me and you will accomplish one of the sacred months, whether the month of Dhul Hijjah. Tomorrow, me and you will enter inside another sacred month, whether the month of Allah, whether the Shahrullah al-Muharram. The Shahrullah al-Muharram, na inna the first month amongst the Muslim, amongst the Muslim of the Islamic calendar, na in symbolize a very great event when the migration of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and the migration of Islam from the land of Kufr to the land of Iman from Makkah al-Mukarramah, that 10 day, not to now, to the Makkah al-Mukarramah, the greatest land of Iman. What if it happened inside in 10 days? For sake of that, Muslims them all over the world, then they reflect upon that wonderful event day, which serve as a turning point in the history of Islam, which serve as a victory for we, the Muslims them. That turning point day, they make all the enjoy Islam so they like it today. That happened inside this wonderful month of Muharram. Respectable brothers and sisters in Islam, this same month of Muharram, they among the sacred mountain where Almighty Allah mentioned inside the Quran. He said, "Inna intata shuhura inda Allah, itna ashara shahran fi kitabillah, yawma khalaqa as-samawati wal-ard, minha arba'atul hurum, thalika ad-dinul qayyim, fala tazlimu fihinna anfusakum. وقاتل المشركين كافة كما يقاتلونكم كافة واعلموا أن الله مع المتقين." Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said the number of months, the number of months to the sight of only Allah, now 12 months them make up the year. He said four amongst them months and a sacred one them. Then sacred months also the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he explained them for me for our hadith, them referred to as hadith of Abi Bakrata. We Bukhari report for say the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam tell you say as-sanatu ithna ashara shahra, he say the year na 12 months day inside it, he say minha arba'atul hurum, he say four pandemons and day na sacred months, he say salasun mutawaliyat, three of them they need together, when dhul qa'dah, dhul hijjah and the muharram. Then he say wa rajab mudar ورجب الذي بين جمادى وشعبان. Then he mentioned the month of Rajab, with it in between the Jumada Athania and the month of Sha'ban. Respected brothers and sisters in Islam, who foresees the opportunity back again of finding yourself inside another very big season by doing good work them, righteous work them. Now that it mean by making them on say as a secret. It simply means to say when you do good work, Allah they multiply for you. When you do bad again, and they multiply again the sin for you. So Lord, be very be careful. And that may the verse say, "Fala tazlimu fihinna anfusakum." Una no wrong una soul sin inside in particular sacred month. Say, when you commit sin, you wrong the soul. Because you degrade yourself. You reduce your spirituality. You reduce your nearness to Allah and keep a distance away from Him when you commit sin. So no dua at all, especially inside the monastery, also one of the sacred monastery. They recommend plenty good work, them include fasting. A kampa hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam tell you say, he say, afdalu siyami ba'da Ramadan, siyamu shahri lahil muharram. The best fasting when you go fast after the fasting of Ramadan, now for fast inside this particular month of Ramadan, inside this particular month of Muharram. They recommend general fasting inside this month, but most specifically, the 10th day when the Yom Ashura. The Ashura, or what we normally refer to as the Yom Bente, now don't come back so again. When a season for we. The time when the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam migrates, come on a market, kind of marina, he meet the Jews, them, then they honor that day, then they greet him with fasting. Then ask them, they say, Mahada. He say, what do you do so? Now they tell their reply. They say, Hada yawmun najjallahu bani Israel min aduwihim fir'aun. Now the day this way, Almighty Allah been saved the Israelites from the enemy way to sin at Fir'aun. He say that the time he talks to him, for second that to the fastest particular day. And the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam tell them, say, Ana ahakku bi Musa minkum. He say, me again right upon Musa past una all. So therefore, he fast the day of Ashura and the commanding companions and for the faster. So for fast on the Ashura, a very important for them, we know say, a very strong sunnah. Where if we fast that day, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala take a wipe off for we mistakes the way we to say we don't commit. Lord Metal Maker is it for we, though over for keep them goodness they are so we be to see the meet we in our life. Lord Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept for we, you judge and the hajj where they perform. Lord Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make this hajj let be hajj mabrur. Let make this sa'i where they do let be sa'i mashkur. Let it make the dhulub they all let be dham makfur. Allahumma rabbana. تقبل منا إنك أنت السميع العليم وتب علينا يا مولانا إنك أنت التواب الرحيم اللهم تقبل من حجاجنا حجهم اللهم اجعل حجهم حجا مبرورا وسعيهم سعيا مشكورا وذنوبهم ذنوبا مغفورا برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين اللهم لا ترنا في مكاننا هذا ذنبا إلا غفرت ولا حما إلا فرجت ولا دينا إلا قضيت ولا مريضا إلا شفيته ولا ضالا إلا هديته ولا حاجة من حوائج الدنيا والآخرة يلك فيها رضا ولنا فيها صلاة إلا يسرتها برحمتك يا رب الرحمين اللهم احفظ أئمتنا اللهم احفظ أئمتنا وولاة أمورنا We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with the mighty names and the great attributes they protect for me the leaders of our country Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect for the leaders of our country. We get plenty of them that we miss today. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless their lives and for we. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guide them towards what is better for the country. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect them for we all. Almighty Allah open for them the doors of goodness and bring come for them more goodness and more prosperity in our country. Allahumma ya Rabbana aati nufusina taqwaha wa zakki anta khayru man zakkaha anta waliyuha wa maulaha. وصلى الله على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين سبحان ربك رب العزة ما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين قوم إلى صلاتكم يرحمكم الله